5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Disruptor!
Dire team pick.
Shadow Demon!
Dire team ban.
Hello.
I hope. I had to do a few, let's say, less than legitimate workarounds, but whatever. It should be fixed for now. Anyway, let's go straight into the picks, and Vega Squadron pick up a very strong Leshrac Shadow Demon. Definitely. And, I know. Like, Leshrac picked? Okay, we have to ban out Shadow Demon now, but opting instead to ban out Beastmaster just in case Mag, you know.
Reserve time.
But anyway, Shadow Fiend Disruptor on LC side. Now, LC have favored Disruptor, I believe. They really like playing with the Disruptor.
Radiant team pick.
Needs assassin.
Ooh, good pick there. And it's good versus the Shadow Demon as well. Also, burn their mana. Who'd fought? Surprise, surprise. Yeah, especially, I mean, Leshrac, his job is basically just to stack up into items.
Reserve time.
Just, you know, just wait out the BKB time, but, you know, anything can happen, and if the Nyx doesn't get a night start, then...
Fuck, I forgot to... I would still have my mic muted, they're just shitting me. Oh my god.
Well then, Twitch chat. Please.
Yeah, they notice it.
He's yours.
I'm gonna get eaten alive right now, I'm sorry. Anyhow, I'll do the introduction real fast again. Welcome to the best of three between Vega and LC in this loser bracket final. The winner of this will face up versus Power Rangers in the best of five grand final. So far, we were mostly talking about Leshrac Shadow Demon being picked up, just being a strong combination, and the Nyx Assassin just being really strong versus Leshrac.
I'm wondering, could they hear
you? Yeah, they could hear you. It was just me.
Slada. I don't think they could hear me.
No, they could.
Okay. Imaginary commentator. Yes. Anyway, this Slardar pickup. Now, a Slardar is not what you see. Let's just put it that way. And to be honest, I think it's actually quite good.
Yeah, just the Minus Armor is able to blow up a Shadow Fiend so fast, as well as a Disruptor. And even Nyx Assassin.
He's not as susceptible to, like, you know, Nyx Assassin ganks or Disruptor ganks.
Yeah, though he still does get blown up by the huge amount of magic damage that there is, but... Yeah,
you know what? In the late game, he doesn't really care that they silence or, you know, stun him. I mean, he cares if he gets stunned, but he doesn't care if they silence him. And, of course, you know, amplify damage on the Nyx. Yes, please.
Indeed.
Ooh.
But the answer back with a puck. He gets a little bit less elusive when you get amplify damage on top of him, but still... It's hard to keep track of it with the current heroes.
Although, doesn't Yule's purge off amplify damage?
Yeah, it does, but...
I mean, it's an actual build-up for Pug.
Then you need Yule's. Before you get Yule's, it's about 20 to 25 minutes, usually.
Vega's picking up a very interesting team here. That's a Windranger.
Yeah, this is, again, a really nice mix of magical damage and physical damage already. Windranger, you know, with focus fire, with amplified damage, just does a lot of damage. Leshrac, you know, physical damage. And then Leshrac just starts running around as the rainbow pony that he is, you know, magic damage everywhere. So yeah. Even if you do get Beaker Beast now, which, you know, Shadow Fiend will naturally get, it still gets just killed by the Focus Fire.
I mean, this implies that Windrunner is going the carry route, but she is a versatile hero, you have to remember that.
That's definitely true.
I mean, she could go anything. She could really do anything.
Yeah, I'm just looking at what is Vega going to do here. Are they going to go, like, maybe dual lace here with SD Leshrac, or they could do, like, a roaming SD Leshrac with Wind Range on the off lane, Slardo on the safe lane, and pick up a mid hero?
They could.
Along those lines.
Vega is very... I mean, they can really pick up a lot here. Thing is, though, it's like LC now has a very... has a solid team. They have a Puck for the mid game. They have the Nyx Assassin. They have Disruptor. They have a decent early game. They have the Chen if they really want to start pushing. And they have the Shadow Fiend saved up for the late game. What the problem I'm seeing here is mainly the late game. Even though they have a Shadow Fiend, it still gets blown up incredibly quickly in the late game.
Yeah, but these heroes definitely. Vega do have the late game, and LC should be able to at least get something done here with the Chen. They should be able to get online quite early. Shadow Fiend, if he... I think Chen will be picking up the mech, so they... Shadow Fiend doesn't have to go for that. He might even rush up into a BKB first, or maybe into a Yule's Blink.
This clinks, though. Hey.
So that's... that still leaves the question, is it an SD Leshrac roaming? Or Windranger support? Or what are they going to do?
This is some very variable lanes here. You can lane this in any way possible.
That is true, they can just do whatever they want here.
Well, Seema the Slayer suggests a Leshrac support.
Yeah, this is
Nike on the offlane.
Yeah, so it's gonna be a roaming Leshrac Shadow Demon. We're gonna see, I'm gonna assume it's gonna be the Windranger on middle now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it doesn't make much sense if it's Slardo mid versus a Puck.
Yeah, that's kind of a... well, actually, it's going to be Slardar versus Keisher.
Keisher's going to go mid, though. Madeira's carry? No, wait, hang on. They're switching up roles here. Madeira is on the Puck. I don't think... are you kidding me? Madeira, really? Madeira. I mean, you're a cool guy and all that, but, you know, you had a lot of time to go to the toilet before this game.
Yeah, but it's still fine. Igor is being the badass, saying that he could 10k more viewers.
You're a funny bastard, Igor. You're a funny bastard. You are hilarious. I'm laughing my ass off, Igor.
But yeah, they're winning in viewers. You're seeing that a lot more often now. Like, there are a lot more Russians watching Dota 2 streams right now. A little bit of drawing on the map here to make sure that you can't do stream snipe, so we'll also do it. Look at this.
Stream snipe in the first few minutes of gaming. Yes, yes, we'll see how everyone's in the fountain doing absolutely nothing.
Yeah, they haven't even purchased one item, so.
Great. Hang on.
Hmm?
All right. Right. Apparently, no one also DC'd.
Oh yeah, that's quite odd. Who actually? But there was a pause from LC, but no one. Okay, well, this is something.
Right, we are confused.
But yeah, this is okay. Since LC boss is going to be from their time, so this is how we're going to see it right now. Anyhow, I want to go over the teams or something like that, but it's not going to be happening. But as it is showing now, we'll be having the Windranger is going to be middle. It's going to be played by no one. Pasha is going to be going on the safe lane with the Slardar here. Seema is going to be the Leshrac together with the Shadow Demon. There's this probably going to start roaming quite early. Well, Mac is going to be the offlane Klinks. And for LC, Skylock is going to be offlane Nyx Assassin. Keisher is from a blue slide, going to be the mid Shadow Fiend with Madeira on the safe lane Puck together with S2 as his support Disruptor. And Spartan is going to go into the jungle as the Chen with the Egyptian head here.
Ooh.
And he got his set, he got it gifted here. From an unknown user.
From unknown user, okay. So dedication right there.
He got some friends, man.
Oh, well, no one's reconnected, but Madeira's still apparently on the toilet.
Yeah, he is.
Madeira!
Bonica Lehe. What the hell does that mean? Take a shit?
Oof.
Go vote for.
All right, I'm just gonna look this up right now.
Okay, yes, sure. Go ahead. Prep for meal. They're all saying a lot of things. Vote for Alexi. What are they actually talking about?
I'm not. Okay. What?
What are you voting for then? Have you checked it?
I don't know what they're voting for.
Okay.
Vote Alexi. Can we play Dota? Yes, you can.
Solo AFK, okay. Yeah, he was actually typing, wasn't he? Mac, no one. Oh, he wasn't back. There was somewhere. Now he left.
Oh, LC, please.
Oh!
LC, what is going on? I'm about to spam the salty emote.
He got flamed by his own team.
Oh, fuck, that's emote.
Phil.
Ah, I'm just going to do it again.
You're gonna do it again?
Yeah, why not?
My dog was typing, okay.
There you go.
Okay, now we'll see how it will actually shape up. But there are no hero switches so far, so it's actually gonna be the safe lane Puck here, trying to get this fast blink dagger.
This is the safe lane Puck?
Yes. Fast blink dagger, start rotating, get kills everywhere.
Okay.
Oh, or never mind. Okay, so no boss.
Yes, the salt was not for you, Meg.
And it's just gonna go actually aggressive tri lane here with solo Seema the Slayer at 9 Bastion. And will they be able to find somebody? Oh!
Ooh.
S2
is. S2 is.
Are you boss? Kidding? No! He should be able to see this. Yeah, he sees this. Okay, Spartan just DCs on the timing that they see Pasha running up. They were nowhere close to get him anyway, but still, it's a little bit tough. Oh well.
All right, I need a translator. Where's that Dota 2 translator that someone made? Hang on a second.
Shout out to Sneaky Guys, I don't know who it is. Okay, and Spartan is ready again. We can. We'll start resuming now. I psyched. If you're saying that I can type, you might as well make sure that you type correctly as well. There we go, we're gonna go back into it again.
Amazing. And no engagements come out of that immensely long pause.
Yeah, we got a couple of pauses in succession there, so.
30 seconds.
But at least they're gonna get off the first ward here. Yeah, this one is probably gonna get spotted. This blocks both the camps. There's a lot of pinging here. No one is still walking there. They might want to try and lay a trap here.
Ooh, but they are sort of out of vision right there. You can't see them there, I believe. Yeah,
oh, no,
that's...
Again, so.
This could be Solo trying to maybe go in and bait. Looks like it.
Yeah, oh! Disruption is there. Is the Spit Earth going to get time?
No.
Yeah, bloody blocking. Spit Earth. No.
No, the range is just too short.
He's just gonna waste two tangos to get out.
That's two tangos gone. Oh, nice
Glimpse
clips.
Back. Solo, he gets his buff block. Seema walks in. He's taking a lot of damage. Illusionary Orb forward. Is he gonna go to it? No, he's not. Even a Split Earth on it to make sure that he doesn't come out.
Tangos were used.
Indeed, but at least he gets a regeneration from it. And we'll now see if they are able to find the wards that are placed. With everybody still walking here, Oh, Spartan. He's walking through the trees. When's the disruption gonna hit? No, that is just gonna keep on hitting him for now. Disruption. They don't even need it!
They don't care! This is amazing! Are they gonna get a kill on S2 as well?
Yeah,
oh
he just
gets.
Oh
my god.
Just disrupt his split over there, you go, another kill. Double kill already for Seema. Man, he's having a time of his life.
And they're just gonna rotate down onto Puck now.
Yeah. Well, they're not able to get him, you know. Mostly due to the fact that disruption is still on the cooldown.
Hey, you know what? A zone is a zone. I'll take that any day.
Yeah. He does get his. It's clarity denied there, so it's a little bit.
See how Skylock is doing on the top lane. I would expect him to not fare so well against Mag, but he seems to be doing all right for himself.
He should be okay, like, should be about even. And Bounce1 is also joining in. He got 20k viewers.
Is that true? I don't believe you. Oh, wait, he's on his. Wow, that's actually fucking true. Oh my god.
Okay, China wins, guys.
Well, we're not gonna argue that. Let's get back to the action of Leshrac and Shadow Demon just blocking camps here.
Yeah, just look at it. Just there's nothing really to be done here by Spartan. He just gets a Welding Ripper, zones out mid here with the tornado, and you know, annoys no one a little bit. But he's still doing okay.
He doesn't really care, no one, because he has that immense range.
Yeah, and another kill there. Seema and Slayer already on a killing spree 2 minutes in. And Spartan will now also take a fall. Will they give him a dominating streak? No.
Yeah,
Tolo wants this one. Now Madeira, he just eats through the trees, keeps on running. And Illusory Orbs out. Yes. Goes to the box back again.
And all this time, Slaughter is just farming up casually. Like, yeah, I'm just going to take all the solo XP.
Yeah, like. You know, he doesn't care about kills, you know, like. Just let them work that out. He doesn't care, he just wants to get his blink.
That is true, that is true.
Ozone is now typing the dots. I don't know what he's actually trying to say with that, but... Quest them later. And Mac, he's doing fine here at home. 11-10, but... Actually, Skylock is winning this quite heavily, but now Searing Arrows will start to do quite a lot of damage.
I just want you to look at the Disruptor quickly and look how much XP that guy has.
Nice. How about that? Well, Slaughter gets a kill onto the Puck Madeira. Nodo TPing out and he's able to make it. No Glimpse there.
I still find it that this is LC is... No.
And they're just pushed back so far. This aggressive Thryland is paying off dividends here.
It's I've got to try this in a pub, just with my team. Just try this out.
Yeah, you're gonna feel so
it
hard.
It probably will, but you know what? You know what? Just it try
be,
it out.
It will be fun. Guys, everybody try out this try lane here, guys. It could be fun.
Or maybe replace the slider for something else.
Well, doesn't matter. But so far, they're just doing so fine here. Look at this perk. Just four last hits and one death. And you know, Parsha just, you know, pops his sprint, starts running after an illusionary roll from out from Madeira, and he will even go to it.
He's so under farmed right now, Madeira. He can't do anything. He's zero, he's four last hits in.
Yeah, it's just nothing. Even Spartan on the Chen has been able to get more. And look at it, he is forced to scout with his Satyr here to make sure that he doesn't get ganked.
Oh, this is not good. No one is farming up casually. Same thing with Mag. I mean, even though Skylark in this lane would arguably be the harder lane for Vega, they don't have to care. It's a melee versus a ranged.
Yeah, like, even if Skylark wins his
lane. Oh dear. Once again.
Oh yeah. Spartan has found.
Missed, but you know what? It doesn't matter.
No, they're still able to get it easily there. No one picks up the kill though.
Ooh, but Seema.
Oh, he might die here. There's a killing spree on him. If Puck's able to get this, no, then don't get it. He's still alive. He might just TP out soon. Oh! Almost close.
Are they overextending here?
Yeah. No. Well, they just come back in here. Pasha is able to pick up the disruptor right now, but Dera, he does have an orb now. He's jolting. Yeah, there we go. He goes to Keisha, pops his health pot, and is able to get out. But now, oh, the race does hit Vega there. Coming solo. Keisha, he gets stunned up. The Satyr comes back in, throws out a nice orb there. Pasha gets an illusionary orb on top of his face. But yeah, they want to get solo, but solo is just too fast here.
Ooh, oh,
no, Glyph's 30 seconds cooldown.
But it's still going to get a kill.
Yeah, there we go. Solo is dead. Disruptor picking up a kill.
No kill on the Leshrac though, which was the important target. So Lesh remains undefeated right now.
Yeah, that was... It would have been a knife bound.
But, you know, can't get everything, but...
Okay, that was a little bit of a wishful jackal shot, I would say.
I guess you could say that, yeah. And net worth is currently 3,000 for Vega. This is after 6 minutes.
Yeah, they're winning the early game really, really hard right now. And he's just looking for more. Like, Spartan is not having a good time at all. He's finally able to purchase some boots at 6 minutes. As a gen, that's actually really, really bad.
Yeah, you want like the mech at 10 or something. If you
like at this moment, you should be having your Kainas and probably have gank maybe a lane or two if it needs to be happening. But yeah. Now it's just, he's going to be so far off his mech timing. And although Keisha's having an okay time with 35, let's say it's when you have a Chen on your team, you kind of don't want to pick up the mechanism on the Shadow Fiend then.
Yep. He's going for Battle Treads, so obviously going for a more aggressive build.
Indeed.
Ooh, here we go. Smoke up from Solo and Seema. Probably want to get Psylocke here. He does have ult, but it's already been used.
It's on cooldown, he doesn't have the mana, disruption is there. They even put down a sentry for good measure. And he does actually evade the first initial damage here, but he's not able to do it after that. And there we go.
There you go.
Dominating
pretty
streak.
Easy kill. And pretty easy kill.
And this Leshrac, he's just gonna get so farmed and fed.
He already has arcanes.
And his magic wand is coming as well. Solo is also has some items already. He already has his boots together with a wand. Building up towards his tranquils now.
Smoke from Chen and Shadow Fiend. I'm guessing Slada wants. Pasha. They want to catch Slada. Oh
yeah, they already have him.
Good kill for Puck. It was a split. Only 169 though, so not enough really.
That's the biggest thing.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Still, a kill is a kill, and that's what they need at the moment, desperately.
Yeah, but they did rotate four heroes for it, and now Keisha has to start running back to mid lane. No one is using illusions to push a little bit into the tower.
Ooh, they're gonna start pushing now. I mean, they have Chen, who can push very, very well.
They don't have Hand of God yet, though.
And that is true.
And just one or two lightning.
Leshrac cannot solo defend this, though.
Oh, but he can just throw out lightnings all the time.
That is true. He's on level 2 lightning, level 2 split turf.
Yeah. And he's even level 3 lightning now.
Shadow Demon is, dangerous place here.
A little bit aggressive.
Ash doesn't hit.
Nope. Went into the one of the keeps here and... My keyboard just keep on going, plugging in and out. It's really annoying. Okay, this should be the last little bit of lag there. I'm sorry, my computer was really annoying when something got plugged in and plugged out. I guess the core just wasn't working with me today. Sorry for that. Anyway. Let's go. Yeah.
What is Keisa delivering? He's got... Actually, Keisa is getting the he's getting the mech.
Oh, he's actually going for it. Yeah, it's to be understood. But Dreamcall is there, hitting two solo. He's gonna get bursted down here. There we go. He breaks the... Dreamcall and will die because of it. Oh, however, they turn it around to Madeira and even Spartan will get killed now. Glimpse back on Mech though. But still, S2 is there. The rotating Keisha as well. No one is on the back trying to fight up versus him. The two races hit him. He has to start walking away right now. Skylock is there. Is he going to hit him? There you go. He's going to die due to the Vendetta strike. The same to Keisha also dies. Skylock is trying to fight in here. He does have Carpus. Will he use it? No, he won't. Oh. He has to use it now. There we go. Keep on running. They still see you. And Pasha gets back.
There's very close kill on the disruptor. Very close kill on the disruptor. Almost TPing out there.
And yeah, the courier died as well in the midst of the fight, indeed. Nice for Vega as well to be able to pick that one up.
They lost two people, but they killed four. Nice fight recap.
Yeah, that was just so in favor of just keep on extending their lead.
And that's the disruption coming out, just to, you know, burn out Skylock. Make sure he can't follow them back into hell or whatever.
He doesn't even have Vendetta. He's on cooldown, so he's not able to really do anything right now.
4,000 net worth for Vega. Completely in their favor right now.
What the fuck is wrong with my key? I didn't have it the last two games, so that's... But okay, they're trying to get something onto no one, but Skylock is actually really drained of his mana here.
Oh, that's what happens.
Yeah. Pasha, he's about, what is it, 700 gold off his blink dagger now.
Just that, you know, and he's gonna get it. He just take down this tower and he's already halfway there.
Yes. One of them not even able to defend it right now. Well, Mac is going to S2 here, the power shot. I did only damage to him, I think.
Mac is always, has almost finished his Orchid.
Man, it's gonna be like a 30 minute Orchid in this way.
Oh my god, that was dangerous.
Now Skylock has used everything, disruption is there, splitter, boom, on top of him. He's gonna take the death.
Yeah, Solo's gonna take a bit of tower damage, but you know what? He doesn't give a shit.
At least right now, LC is able to claim the first tower of the game, taking down. Mid tower. Side of Vega.
Still, it's that mag that's getting farmed. It's Solo picking up kills, it's Leshrac picking up kills.
Look at it, Seema. He has 5-0-6.
Oh, but Nightpash has to watch out here.
Vera, he's going forward, but he's just gonna go into Meg here. And he doesn't even need him. Power shot just... perfectly on Mark.
Yes. Yo, green dudes, something... Interesting engagement top as well. Wanted to go a gank on Nightpash, but ultimately good stun saves his life.
And now he's only 200 gold off his blink. So once he gets it, we'll see even more aggression from Vega.
The delivery going, yep, that's the mech finished up on the Shadow Fiend. Late if you want to put it by chance standards, but you know what, it's what they need anything right now.
They just need something to be able to do.
Like, what can they do to come back? They need like a perfect dream coil into Requiem Initiation here.
Pretty much. And then with Static Storm, Kinetic Bow, and...
And even then, they need to kill the Leshrac first.
Yeah, and they need to kill the Mag as well, and they need to kill Parsha, so...
It's and everyone is currently really farmed, so...
Yeah. Well, not everyone.
Fine, Solo, sorry about that, but you know...
Solo is like at the bottom. He's just the second...
Ooh, Nine Pasha.
Just got out.
Yeah, Sprint is doing its work there, level 3. Oh, cancel TP, they're gonna sack this tower most likely. Oh, nice!
The hand of God is used there, though, but S2, he will actually be able to survive through this. And Pasha will die now. Seema is stuck, he gets a Waning Rift into him, he is silenced now and he will die. He should get a double kill. This is what they needed.
Overextending, that was too... that was not good.
A nice 417. Shadow Fiend there with the kill on the Leshrac. Who is, mind you, just a support.
Well, at the moment. He actually just bought an Ogre Club. He's going BKB first.
Yeah, he wants... He just got his own. Well,
Solo
and...
No one.
He's gonna take the ball here.
They
also find Solo. That's another double kill for LC.
What is Vega doing?
They're pretty much just going in one by one, just a bit out of...
Hub feed.
Well, Skylock is also taking a lot of damage.
Oh, there you go.
Pretty low, pretty HP, but we can get out. And LC just started to 5-man up and just started taking shit.
Like I said, they needed that. That was something they needed. They just needed the feed from... It was a feed. I'm sorry, that's what I have to call this. They overextended. They overextended way too much here. Bad is happening in your
bottom. That's something they should have done. Once one, my message was delayed by 5 minutes. What?
Well,
okay. I don't know what the message he was talking about.
Look, Vake are gonna go in for the risky strats and just straight up going Rosh here, but they know it's they're going Rosh. LC know they're going Rosh.
Rosh is so
melting.
Fast.
Rosh is melting.
DD on Meg, amplify damage. Just too much. They will get in the mid golem now, but it's already too late. Echo shots hit him, but doesn't match up. All the creeps of the chain are really, really low.
Hand of God. Oh, there you go.
What's up?
Oh, solo!
He's just trying to go in there. Madeira goes in aggressively. Solo has a. There's already a Glimmer Cape on the side. The Static Storm does keep him in just barely there. Requiem of Souls really doesn't hit anybody there on the side. Just applies the debuff pretty much.
Oh, Pasha
gets glimpsed back a little bit and Keisha also
jackal.
Dies.
That yeah, jackal, though.
That harpy.
Dispositioned.
This Glimmer Cape already on CMA, man. Yes, indeed. I'm getting really hard.
There you
go. Is it cold in Switzerland?
No, it's running pretty warm. Yes, no, but that Glimmer Cape, definitely. I thought he was going to go for a Bloodstone first, but you know what? He's roaming, so why not just get a Glimmer Cape for that added effect? Keeping Solo alive for a good amount of time, he's able to get off the Sunbifle spells before he dies.
S2 is found. My damage isn't in, man. Pasha was.
Will they be able to take us down?
But still, even though Vega lost a lot, they were just able to regain pretty much all of it back straight away. Even a little bit more XP.
Have a look at net worth. It's 5,000 back again, and it's 5,000 on the 5,000 on net worth. Keisha is leading in net worth though, and that's just because, I mean, it's Shadow Fiend. He's a natural farmer.
Indeed, but he still won't be able to really stand up versus Mac one.
That is
Mac
true.
Sees Spartan. He knows everybody else is there as well. Oh no, he is found. Yeah, to start running away. Junkle is used as well, so Dust. He's just gonna
nice
get disrupted
disruption.
Here. Yeah, just keeping him there, keeping him safe. Glimps back, but it doesn't really matter. Static Storm. Will they use the Glimmer Cape on him? No, they won't, but they were still able to pick up kills left, right, and center. Skylark went down first, but bought back. Madeira died as well. So far, they're not really able to do anything against this. They just lost three people and a buyback.
Not a very good situation. That buyback should not have been done.
Now, there's another plus to the 2k gold swing and XP swing for Vega to bring him over 7k easily. There you go.
Yeah, and that means, and then now they have total map control.
Just gonna dive behind the tower to get Keisha, are they?
Oh.
They know that he walked there, yeah.
They are? Wow. Okay.
No one should be on the front here yet.
Yeah, I mean, they can take the tower hits. And Keisha, will you be able to TP out in time? No,
they know where he is.
Yep, they see him.
He gets shackled to the tree as well. He's not even gonna get a Requiem or anything else up. Well, the backlines, Madeira is looking for Seema, but Seema just uses his Glimmer Cape and starts running away. Yeah,
ooh,
they got the kill there.
Kill Soto, though.
Yeah, but he does lose his life for it, and it's just a support there, so it's not that big. Well, the backline. Back was kept in there, but still the death there.
Thanks to the. What's
Soul
called?
Burn.
Yeah, Soul Burn, there you go.
Opuk.
Yeah, it pucks out.
This blink is really, really late for a safe lane farming, but
I mean, he didn't have much of a choice. He was up against a very tough tri lane. Oh, Mike Pasha's once again on his own, but he doesn't care.
Mike's just fighting versus Skylark. He bought a little bit of time with the Carpus and other stun, but you know, you can't escape from a slaughter like that. That's just not gonna work. But the stress of now, and we'll be looking at what he will be building next. Might even just go straight into a BKB. There you go.
By the way, you don't have your net worth stats up.
No, now it's this. I accidentally misclicked. Because the keyboard was acting up everything. Right?
Okay.
So once I saw it, I already put it back in. And oh no, Madeira is found. Still, he was quick enough on the fingers to blink away from that. And now there's straight up smoke up again here. They want to try and bait a little bit here with Keisha on the top lane. And Pasha sees them, he gets off the amplified damage, and they will start running back again. Well, Mech finds Madeira, Orchid on him. Look at this damage going, and just an easy kill for Mech on a unstoppable streak already. 6-0-6. And
there you go.
S2 will still die to the Klings here with the bird damage. It's already a double kill for him now again.
Now this is just going to be a very easy tell. They don't even
Blink forward, Spartan. He gets amplified damage, lightning on him as well. He has to use Hand of God, but it is not enough to keep him alive.
They were fighting under a tier 3 there, and they really didn't care.
Just kept on going.
What?
They're really, really far ahead right now. Over 12k. Hearing the 14k already. And over 10k. This is about 500 XP more per minute. And nearing about 700 gold per minute more.
No one has a maelstrom. He's going to go BKB now.
Okay, he's not going Lester's build or anything along those lines. So he's just going to go a little bit more old school, I want to say. Just,
oh, they see Skylark. Do they?
They just did it. There's going to be the impale. Bataburn. Dira goes in, but he just gets orchided up. So he can't do anything anymore. And this Static Storm is just off the mark. He's taking a lot of damage through this BKB. Absolutely did nothing with solo. He will die for it. 2-for-1.
But you know what? It was 2-for-1. And solo basically was a distraction there.
Yeah. And they will also get the tier 2 here as well.
That's it. All tier 2s. No, actually, they're still missing top.
Yeah, top still.
Got to collect them all, basically.
A bit of a Pokemon game here. And see, they will just go get the tier 2. No, then reset, take Rosh, then look for high ground. Maybe get a pick off before they do it.
Yeah. Well, that's it, really. Mags. BKB's coming up everywhere on Vega's side. Really. They're going to come up in the next 2 minutes. Soul Ring. Yeah, Seema's basically going Bloodstone right now.
Well,
he's only about 1,000 off.
They do have a Chen Aghanim at 22 minutes now. It's a Rust Aghanim, but still.
It's something.
Yeah. The Golems are still quite hard to deal with at this stage, but Everfly damage will make it quite easy to kill them, and there's actually no Golem.
Ancient Golem?
Yeah, that one. No Ancient Golem, just a dragon. So.
Still a dragon.
Yeah, he will do with it. For now, until he gets another chance to maybe. Nice Golem there, so. Back, he got his BKB now delivered as well. Another K gold hit to his back pocket. I'm just gonna imagine he's either gonna build an Desolator after this or an Abyssian. Solo, he's still just, oh man, he's just at the bottom of the network of everybody. He's pretty much like Solo, almost the entire team of London Conspiracy, then Madeira, together with Seema. We actually overtook their position one. And, oh no, they actually get no one here on top. But he pops his BKB and will start burning this one around till Skylark. Focus Fire is on him, taking a lot of damage, and he will die here.
You do realize he had 312 health throughout that entire ordeal. They could have probably have done something.
But then you have to commit, and there were already the whole side of Vega were going into it. And Solo is quite aggressive here. He does have no mobility at all, so he just gets blown up here.
I'm asking myself why Solo is just walking in here.
I don't know. He just wanted to get his guard out, but it was so obvious.
I feel like he's kamikazing here.
Doesn't matter that much. Maybe just winning some time while Mech can look to kill Keith here. Maybe force out another BKB charge.
Mag is really playing it up. I mean,
he's just looking.
It's down to 20,000 net worth.
He does get pinged out though.
Oh, they know he's. But
yeah, but he's gonna get silence. Waiting Rift is there. BKB pop. He tries to fight a bit, but just starts to be it out, and he's not able to make it. 628 gold going to Madeira.
That was a mistake. That was a definite mistake. You should not have fought that.
That was a little bit too aggressive. Skylock is going after Seema here. Beamcore is there as well in the back from Madeira, but Glimmer Cape is already used. He's taking almost no damage from all of this magic.
And there's goes Skylock.
Yeah, Skylock is stuck in 2 or 3 and he will just die here. BKB pops a good message to make sure he doesn't get him. Ooh. Bit of hit Madeira there. He also gets the kill. Now the
Now the Granny Dome has to start running away. He's here in Balkan. Oh, misses his first race, does hit the second one. Rickham of Souls being wound up. Solo is hit by it. He's also stuck in this kinetic field second storm combination. And he will just take a fall here. Valsima starts to walk in here, but he needs to get out. He will try to return.
Denies himself.
Yeah, he denies. Oh man.
Viewers receive a prize. Interesting. Viewers receive a prize. Interesting. Did not know that.
Yeah, we're a it's a professional tournament, so yeah. You get enough viewers to start handing out gifts.
Well then, good rush by Slada. Using the distractions on the top lane as a sort of, you know, distract. Well, yeah,
distraction,
opportunity
to get the rush, yeah, that's good. And with Slada with an Aegis now, they will just wait for no one to get back and then just start going at it again.
Magno going with a Mithril Hammer isn't the only item. No, he's going Mail. He's going Mjolnir. That's a later, but.
Just blow them up.
Is that a unique attack on a. Oh wait, Kling's arrows aren't like the unique attack modifying. No.
Yeah. He has no unique attack on.
It's interesting. It's I always thought Kling's arrows were
no,
a unique attack
modifier.
That has
been patched out like 4 patches ago.
I thought it was like last patch or something. Oh well. Yeah, you see.
And I'm talking about 4 major patches, not the ABC.
Yeah, I do realize that.
No,
no
I'm saving for the chat before I'm gonna get all chewed out.
Yeah, you see, I don't play enough clicks.
Or you don't guess enough.
Oh, you know, he's not picked up too much, to be honest.
That's true. He gets picked up by Empire from time to time with Silent. He's, but in this game so far, he has been working out 818. He's just doing fine. And...
Someone just popped the BKB, I feel like. Oh, yeah, it was no one. I had to use to get away. So that's an 8-second BKB.
But still, they have the Aegis now, so they will just keep on going anyway. They have a Glimmer Cape to save him if need be. Don't have
that item. That very nice item. Here we go, and that's an easy tower.
We even forgot to say, we did say that, of course, Sima denied himself with the ult, and he has his blood sound. This 4th position, Bezrek has just turned into the 3rd position here. Close.
Oh, Skylark. No.
They just start laying damage into this tower here. Well, Spartan is trying to push out middle here, but he's not as fast as no one here.
I feel like we're gonna see a. I feel like we're gonna see a hybrid slash as no one here because he did go get an Aghanim's.
Yeah, but this is not the slasher. The slasher is.
Yeah, Aghanim's Chris.
So no BKB in between as well. Waning Rift. No, he's not using it yet, and that will actually mean his death here. Here we go. He gets completely blown up. The Golem is there. The Flickstorm Kinetic Field is really nice. No one will take a fall here because he has no BKB. Skylark, he gets stunned up with a crush. He falls down, blown up. Oh, Mac, he's looking for more. He finds Kishu. He's going to get hit by the Split Earth. He's going down as well. Double kill, buyback again used by Skylark. Will he be able to do anything? Well, they're still finding him versus Pasha here. Pasha is really low, but still has the Aegis. He might just want
and
to.
And there goes Rax.
Yeah. Might just want to keep on pushing here and just let Pasha die.
Do you realize Nyx has a Midas?
Oh, I did not know that.
Well, there's going an for Eagle late Song game. Actually up on Shadow Fiend, doesn't
he?
Oh, whoa, that S2. Goodbye, S2. You just got deleted from the game.
So, he just buys back instantly anyway. They need to defend the tower right now. I love he's looking. Oh, so just scrape Spartan. And Blink 4 from Pasha, but he already activated the Carpus there, but he still just gets completely blown up.
I'm just putting it this way, they're deleting players from the game now.
Yeah, he's out for 60 seconds. They're gonna lease their Rex second lane as well. This might just be the end for London Conspiracy and MTC here. And the Blink 4 from Madeira, this will be their last hold. He can be popped. Pasha still has the Aegis, so even if he dies, here you go, he dies, but no, he actually gets saved by the disruption. He still has the Aegis.
Oh, he's dead.
Okay, he is dead. Okay, he's finally dead. They finally get the Aegis, but he doesn't care. He's just okay with losing that. And they're looking for Madeira right now, and he was just gonna duel out there. And they're gonna lose for another lane of Rex. Well, they have 3 people down. This is GG. They call it Vega in the Grand Finals versus Power Rangers.
Yay.
You're happy.
Well, well played, LC. No, I'm not. I'm not. I have to stay unbiased. But you know what? Well played, LC. You know, you did well in the first match. You did. You held on in the second match, and you totally got stomped in the last match. But you know what? You had some good times, right, LC? Yeah.
They got really far into a tournament. They're not going home empty-handed for that case. At least get 500 euros. So. Yeah, let's see if they will win their Razer Think Fest Cup, though. They're currently there. I believe they're playing from their hotel, so... Not the most ideal... not the most ideal situation for them. But they did play it. I want to thank them for that. And Vega, though, having to go through the entire loser bracket, they are able to fight their way back up to the Grand Finals, a little bit Navi style there. You're gonna fight versus Power Rangers to win the 3,000 euros.
And that will be an interesting game. A best of five.
Honestly, and I don't know who's gonna win it. Vega are probably the favorite.
Although Power Rangers have shown their worth.
I think it's gonna be about 60 to 40% though.
Well, we'll see.
We'll see. We'll start scheduling that match. We'll keep you all updated on that. And thank you all for watching. I'm Sander, I'm the one of the casters of Swiss DC. Together with me is Morality Class, also one of the Swiss DC casters. I hope you guys enjoyed our casting. Tomorrow we will be sending out the Swiss Championship. That will be casted by Morality and Zach. Make sure to tune in for that. That is the qualifiers, the Swiss qualifiers. And if you win the national thing there, yeah, then you go to the World Championship. Cup. And you will play versus Newbie.
Hmm? Which is very hard. Which is some prestige. I got to tell you that.
Yeah, this. I forgot where they're actually going to be playing the World Championship of Dota. But guys, just look it up, and also just come check in my insanity Swiss squad. The Swiss squad of there is already through into the offline event of us. So I hope to see you guys all tune in tomorrow as well, and we'll see you all later.
Goodbye.